you're publishing a paper in JAMA Oncology about ovarian cancer and chemotherapy. So tell us about this paper.
This was a very exciting study, although it was very small, only in 24 patients. But the investigators questioned whether the tumor stroma proportion could predict those patients who didn't respond to chemotherapy. So they divided the patients up into those that had less than 50% tumor stroma proportion and those that had greater than 50% tumor stroma proportion. And they found that the tumor stroma proportion was really an excellent indicator of those patients who wouldn't respond to chemotherapy. And the beauty of the study is you can make the diagnosis or quantitation of tumor stroma proportion on simple hematoxylin eosin staining that we do on all tumors.
Tell us a little bit about tumor stroma.
Tumor stroma is the fibrous material that really encapsulates a tumor. So oftentimes when we think of invasive cancer, we think of it like fingers growing all through tissue. But many cancers are actually in little balls encased by material that really prevents anything from penetrating into the cancer. And we've come to realize that having very robust stroma in your tumor can be a bad prognostic indicator.
And how do you see this potentially being used in the clinic?
Potentially, it would be a good prognostic indicator for people to know at the time they're diagnosed with ovarian cancer. We're having so many different therapies come into play in ovarian cancer. You might use this and then say to the patient, we're going to add something to your therapy or put you right away on a clinical trial that may be using drugs that would modulate the stroma. So the clinical impact today might not be immediate, but it may be a way that we can offer the patients new treatments that they may respond to better.